Hi folks, here is my new tool, or toy, that I got a few weeks ago from Orange Pie. I bought that on Amazon.com. It's an Orange Pie 4B, so it's a special version of the Orange Pie 4 with a NPU. I already had a few RK3399 from Orange Pie, but I have a new project in which I need an NPU because I want to make some tests with TensorFlow. So here it is. I received it a few weeks ago but haven't had time to open it. So let's do that together today. Ah, here is a beauty. So Rockship 3399, as we can see it there in the anti-static bag. So I'll just open it with scissors, I'll be right back. So let's make a quick review of what's on the board. First of all, the famous GPIO, so 40 pins header like the Raspberry Pi. Then of course the heart of the machine, the Rockship RK3399. Then we have the 16GB eMMC flash, the Ethernet chip, which is there. So it's a RTL8211E, then we've got the Gigabit Ethernet plug, then the SPR28OS. That the reason why I bought this board is just there. So it's a neural processing unit,
what?
NPU, but I will detail later on. For the time being, let's just say it's pretty powerful. Typical calculation power at 2.8 tops with 9.3 tops per watt. Then we've got two USB 2.0 ports and the Wi-Fi chip, which is an AP6256. Then the power barrel, so it's a 5.5 by 2.1, which will take 5 volts, 3 amps DC power unit. And then, speaking of power, we've got the PMU, which is there. It's an RK808. And then we've got a USB 3 Type-C, which can be used to power the board or just be used as a standard Type-C USB so that you can plug in whatever USB-C type device you may need. Then we've got the HDMI out, supposedly compatible with HDMI 2.0. And then the audio in and out, which is a standard mini jack 3.5. Then we've got a connector for a camera. Orange Pie sells a 13 megapixel camera for around $15. It's the same one as the one used on the Orange Pie RK3399. On the left part, we have the Wi-Fi antenna. Then we've got the memory, the 4GB LPDDR4, which is pretty nice because the other boards I own are all DDR3. Then we've got the connector for the LCD or camera 2. Then the 3 pins, which will allow us to use a debug TTL UART to USB device, which will prove handy from time to time. And then an inboard mic, because why not? Now, if we flip the board, what will we see? A high level of integration, that's for sure. So we've got on the left the LCD one, so another connector for a screen. And we also have the recovery button just next to it. On the right side of the board, we have the reset button, which is just there. And of course, an SD card slot, and that's all. Less is more, so that's pretty cool. Now, let's just power the board and see what it will start with. I think by default we have an Android version supplied by Orange Pie, but sooner or later I will have to try Ubuntu or even Armbian. So, as you have seen, the board starts by default with an Android version, which is already installed on the eMMC. It's fast,
like really fast. But beware, give it a good power unit or it will fail during the boot or after having booted. No cheapo 5 volts WAN amp phone charger with a micro USB to barrel adapter or micro USB to type C adapter. No, no, no. Been there, done that. Anyway, just after that, as I don't plan on using Android on this machine, I downloaded and burned on the SD card the Debian image that Orange Pie supplies. It worked reasonably well. Well, until I installed Rosetta on top of it. That led to lots of stability problems. But what is Rosetta, you may ask? Let me say a few words about it. I was supposed to use my Orange Pi 4B to work on the automatic subtitle project of mine, but the COVID-19 appeared and everything stopped. Except that, I saw a few people on Twitter who were working on something related to COVID-19, and that thing was called Rosetta at Home. I'm sure you can remember SETI at Home if you're as old as I am, you know, trying to interpret signals coming from space in a distributed way. Lots of tiny workloads spread along tons of machines. This is the same kind of project, except it's not trying to decode signals coming from outer space, but trying to create protein models that could help in fighting the COVID-19. There were a few videos, some articles regarding that subject, and I was not late into the game, but I was not the first, that's for sure. David Tischer and Sahaj Sarup worked a lot to bring that to the ARM processor because beforehand it was not available for ARM processor, and as soon as they published that it was working for them and it had been accepted by the Rosetta at Home team, I started all the machines I had which were compatible with that. The Pi 4B is compatible with Rosetta, and by compatible I mean 2 GB of RAM, 4 is better, and a 64-bit processor. That's why my 4B has not been working on the automatic subtitles project of mine yet, but crunching numbers and creating protein models since the beginning of March. A few weeks ago, I was lucky enough to get some help for my projects as a trainee finally joined remotely the team. He's now working on the automatic subtitles project, so I think that in the following weeks, I will slow down Rosetta at Home on this 4B so that we can make a few tries with that machine. As I told earlier in this video, this board sports an NPU, so we'll use a supplied SDK to get better performance or results with automatic subtitling. As for the automatic subtitling, well, I haven't tried to install anything NPU related on the board yet. As it is running Ambient, it may prove difficult or even impossible for the time being. Time will tell. Quentin and I are focusing on a lightweight speech recognition engine these days, Pocket Sphinx. It's not good out of the box with the bad French accent of mine and IT word, but we'll see if we can ameliorate that with adaptation. By the way, I have written a short how-to about installing a Pocket Sphinx dependency on my blog. Next step, try to follow the Orange Pi tutorial for Cafe or TensorFlow with the hope it will use the NPU. As you can see, my 4B does not have a proper case yet, just a big Northbridge heatsink with a fan on it. It's pretty efficient, but not really handy. Not beautiful. I will make a try this time at designing a case, as Orange Pi designed a case that doubles as a heatsink. It does look good too and should be available in black, silver and pink. 500 of them have already been manufactured and I'm waiting for them to appear in the shop to buy one. We'll see how much of a difference it makes with my current setup regarding the temperature. That should be covered in an upcoming video. Until there, thanks a lot for watching, and don't forget to tinker. See you.